Another edition of Sam Choy's in the Kitchen. I'm John Benary. This is Chef Sam Choy, and today we're visiting a very good friend of mine in Laie, Mr. Tanoai Reed, AKA the Rock Stunt Double.
He also played football with you.
We did, we played football together. He's been a good friend of mine for 30 years. Also, another good friend of yours.
Yes, the legend, the myth, the one and only Cap. The guy that walks around the world with no shoes.
They've done some things together recently. They are super good friends. They decided to take a break from the movies and the Polynesian Cultural Center to have us over to cook.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having
welcome
us.
Welcome to Fale Tanoi.
Fale Tanoi.
And I just want to welcome you to our house.
Thank you.
You are our guest today.
Thank you very much.
Guest of honor. And we're going to acknowledge you with a little ava just to get everything started off right and smooth. So,
thank you for a very special day. Thank you very much.
Thank you for friendship.
Thank you for being here and sharing space with us on this beautiful day in my house so we may cook for you.
Yeah, avaletua. Pour some out a little bit of it on the ground, say avaletua.
Avaletua.
God's Kava. We say manuia.
Manuia.
And soifua.
Soifua.
Good living. Yeah, let's do it.
We're going to cook some food today. I hope you're hungry. Well, it's going to be a couple hours, but we have the umu waiting for you. Cap's gonna make the fire. You guys ready?
Yeah. Yep. Ready.
Let's do it.
All right. Tai lava. Yay! Bangui lava. All right, we got the fire.
Yeah.
So we put him in there?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right, man.
Yeah, nobody can beat you and make fire.
All the fuel you need.
A little wire. Yeah.
Oh, there we go.
Yep.
3 minutes. Nice. Put them in there. The idea is burn this. Coconut shell has meats, has the oil. As soon as those guys burn up.
Yeah. Don't inhale. Yeah.
Don't inhale.
Yeah, you need the air to circulate, especially in this. But you see the metal, this is
the
a little updated version. It's the microwave version.
Yeah. Microwave.
Microwave version. The metal retains the heat better, so it's only about a few hour cook time.
So this is burning pretty good. What's next?
We're gonna put some more rocks on and let the fire heat the rocks up, but that's gonna be a little bit. So for now, let's go prep the food because there's a lot of work to do ahead of time.
Okay guys, what are we doing?
We're making a reverse lau lau.
Reverse lau lau.
Yeah, have you heard of it?
Oh,
first time, wow. Well, I guess I invented it then.
Yeah, you so did, man.
Basically, we take a whole chicken and we're gonna marinate the luau leaf in a marinade and we're gonna shove it inside. Wow. And we're gonna smother it, wrap it in a tea leaf, and put the whole chicken in the umu.
Nice.
Awesome. Yeah, awesome. It keeps it nice and moist from the inside.
Yeah, I never had that, but so, marinate the leaf too, man.
Yeah, marinate the leaf too. So,
what do we do?
So I like to use, teriyaki sauces. This is my favorite ones. The Hawaiian honey, aloha pineapple.
Aloha marinade.
I'll show you right here. Yes.
Aloha show you.
Pour them in there.
Oh, okay. Go in a bowl, man.
Yeah, one full. I actually have three chickens. We'll make one right now, and then we'll cut some garlic in there. Get the luau leaf, it's been already kind of de-stemmed. Got a loam in there because it's the luau leaf doesn't really absorb, so you kind of got this coated in there.
Yeah.
And it'll start to absorb a little bit. I brined the chicken overnight, so it's nice and tender.
Right.
I brined it in sugar, salt, and some garlic.
Where'd you learn this?
I kind of made it up, man. I love cooking.
Really?
That's one thing people don't know about me. I do a lot of stunts, but I love cooking.
In
the Samoan culture, the men do the cooking. So
is it a requirement, like when you're on a set?
Actually,
No.
I do meal prep at home, but I mean, when I'm working. But I like to cook for my wife, my family.
Yeah.
It's been something I've been, it's kind of like Zen-like for me. It's kind of a meditation.
That's awesome.
And you want to put him breast down, of course, because the umu is hot and it'll dry out. So put the breast down, and let's get some of this goodness here. Just kind of mop it on top there.
Yeah, the brushing in there.
Yeah. We'll wrap it up here.
Okay.
Right there. This keeps it nice and moist. That's how you make the reverse lau lau. Easy.
Cap, tell us what went into this.
So this is the, it's kind of nice to know that we have a foil pan and then inside the foil is the leaf. The kind of give the flavor of it. Still kind of meeting the new world and the old world here. It kind of, you know, keep in touch with our natural way of doing things before. And then we got the pork cut up and then we have onion, salt, and garlic in there.
And then this piece is going to go right on the rock.
Yeah, it's going to touch the rock.
Oh, it's going to touch the rock. Okay. Now, if it's touching the rock, it's going to cook a little quicker? Is that how that works?
Yeah, we're going to look at the way the oven burns, and we look at it, so we put the food in, we kind of know where the heat is at, the pattern of the heat, and then we're going to place it according to that.
What's in the pan?
So this is prime rib right here. I like to make prime rib because it comes out really good in the umu. There's a couple of things you got to remember. Keep the fat side up.
Okay.
So when it cooks, the fat seeps down. It keeps it moist.
All the flavor.
And the flavor, right?
All the flavor, yeah. I like to use oyster sauce for it. So I just dump the oyster sauce on it.
We're going to get your hands dirty again.
Get the hands dirty. Just load me that bugger in.
You can open it for him.
Yeah.
Is this what's the deal with the oyster sauce? Because that's the first time I've seen the oyster sauce.
Oh, this has flavor. Yeah, it's got everything in there, right? So kind of like a seasoning.
You know oyster sauce, like oyster sauce, beef oyster sauce, broccoli, Chinese, you know, cooking? Yeah, it has the sugar, helps it brown a little bit because of sugar in it.
The caramel color.
Yeah, the caramel color. It brings the meat a nice flavor. And I got this prime rib. First time I'm using this, I haven't used this before. It's a prime rib mix, I just kind of coated on there.
Tanoai, just don't get me, open that for you, buddy.
I got him, bro. I know. Open.
Prime rib mix. Thing. What would normally go on that, Uncle Sam?
Oh, pretty much what he's doing right now. Like just the rub, the dry rub.
And then you want to grab the...
It's a mix already made.
Got the tea leaf, we'll wrap it with the leaf.
If you don't have the mix, though, what I
guess... Oh, you can make garlic salt,
Hawaiian salt, garlic salt, this has everything in it already.
Okay.
Yep. Put in there.
Fat side up.
Yeah, fat side up.
And it's the fat side up because?
Fat side up because as it cooks, the fat will seep into the meat and keep it
flavors,
juicy.
Yeah,
the flavors. It helps it to hydrate it actually as you cook it. Yeah, so it won't dry out.
And then the flavors, of course.
Yeah, the flavor. Yeah.
And then, see how quick that was? You just slap it on, rub it on, and that's it. It's really easy. The umu cooks it so perfectly, it takes care of everything. Like the flavor will be there. It's nice and moist.
We cook the taro in the pot, and this is how you check if it's cooked. So you take a fork, and make sure you poke it through, and it's pretty good. This big one back here, it's pretty good. So we're gonna go with the skin, take it out, we're gonna put it in cold water and peel the skin off. That's good.
Cap's in the kitchen, working on some stuff in the kitchen. Uncle Sam, we're gonna be doing a fish dish.
Branzini.
But we also have bok choy. Okay. So everything in here we have to use. And courtesy of our great friends at both Salty Wahine and Rosalani Ice Cream, we have guava garlic salt.
Oh, guava garlic salt, perfect. Right there.
Beautiful. And fiery dragon fruit and Java steak rub.
Oh man, a steak rub gonna be right on the fish.
Okay, and then we'll
have... We'll stunt this fish right here.
This is gonna be good. This is the granddaddy size of Rosalani Ice Cream's banana mac crunch.
You gotta use that on the fish.
No, but we'll be using it for sure.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah, we'll use it somehow today.
Yes.
Oh man, there's Cap. Okay.
Taro.
Uncle Sam, you gonna use the salty wahine products?
Yes, I'm gonna use
this. This is gonna go back in the freezer for a little while, and let's get cooking with the
Branzini. John, you want to shush it, and you can
make
something
like,
make like this. Yeah, all the way around. Yeah, very nice. Look at that.
All right.
Couple chili.
Try this.
Yeah, right. We get
it. Okay.
So I'm gonna put them just like this.
This is really, really, really good.
Okay, we're gonna season one. We're gonna roll them all tight. Okay. Bring me some of the big prime time stuff.
What the? Oh, the prime time? Yeah.
Just a little.
Just adding a little bit of that.
We close her up like this.
So you butterflied it.
Yeah, butterflied.
Layered it with green onions, white onions. We've salted and peppered it.
Yeah. No, we can put them like this and then
close
them all up like that.
That looks pretty amazing.
Yeah, you can put three on top.
Sam Choi's in the kitchen. Hotel accommodations provided by Ala Moana Hotel.
Hey An hour past the Golden Gate Bridge brings you to the place where early Spanish settlers discovered 18 square miles of earth fecund for the growing of grapes. Today, there are more than 500 wineries producing some of the best vintages in the world.
But Napa is much more than wine. At one time, this region was known for its wheat, which was ground into flour right here at the old Napa Mill.
Honoring that agricultural history and use of local ingredients is Sweetie Pies, often the first stop for locals and guests of the Napa River Inn.
You know, where you're in California, you can get fresh most of the year. All of our berries and everything are all local. We only use peaches when they're in season.
And following another Cali trend, Tony has coached her staff on adjusting to modern healthy diet concerns.
We have a vegan muffin, we have a gluten-free muffin and a gluten-free scone on the menu all the time. We have flourless chocolate cake that's rolled with marshmallow cream and then glazed in chocolate. That is a gluten-free cake.
Sweetie Pies in the Napa Mill is continuing and furthering the tradition of culinary excellence in the Napa Valley. Now back to Sam in the kitchen.
All right, Cap, we've done this before, but it's time for the Palusami.
Yeah, we're Palusami. So Palu means mixed, Sami means water from the ocean. So remember, there was no salt. It came from there. We got taro leaf. Samoa usually used to just the middle one.
How come you picked the tip?
It says the old people used to say it will itch if you don't take it off.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Twist.
I want to say we've made this before with Cap.
All right, you know what's in here?
It's so good.
Coconut. You saw Cap squeeze this from the coconut.
Yeah. Onion and salt.
That onion salt.
One scoopy.
One
scoop.
Gracia.
Gracia.
So here's a taro leaf. Here's the papaca leaf.
Okay.
And foil.
Papaca leaf.
Yeah. It's the cheese right here. Right there. Yeah.
Wow, you get everything growing over here.
One-stop shop. It's like Costco back
there. It is right here.
Right here.
It's in the
ice box across the street.
See that right here, right there? You see through the window? This is the leaf over there. Yeah. Ulu. This is the La Ulu. The Uluwea. We call it Uluwea. It came from Wea Futuna. Wherever it came from, we named it that. Look for a nice leaf. One is called the Samoan crab. The same thing. Wherever it came from, we call that. So you can use either way. So Sue make one today. That's with the leaf turning like this. So we make ours the leaf like that. So that way Sue can
know which one.
Yeah.
So, you see, nowadays everybody's foil, but it's the original way. Right. Yeah, it tastes actually better. Way better.
Very flavor.
Yeah, more flavor.
So here, it's too long. You feel that? I'm sure you have teeth when you cook.
Yeah. Hey, when you come over here, when you no more teeth, how do you do it?
All right, so.
Okay, get going, Cap.
Okay.
100 more. So there we
are. He's looking at you like he wants your help. You're looking at him. I'm going. Hurry up and finish.
We have the fire is cranking up, so we got a
Bavavi.
Bavavi.
Make quick.
This fire is hot.
Essentially, right now, the food is going into the oven.
Right. And then, you know, we lit the emu about 2 hours ago, and then now they removed all the wood,
the burning woods, yep.
The logs, and then all the coal and the hot rocks, they had to readjust it to make sure they had a nice level bed. And they looked at that time, they looked where the hot spots were, because the prime rib and the chicken and the pork had to go that side, and then the palusami and the other stuff went in the other smaller emu. But then, what we did is we added the leaves on top of that, but before that they had put the banana stumps on top of the rocks.
Right. So layering it all on top of the rocks so that it cooks evenly in the umu, and then it's the really important thing is to seal it all up because you don't want that heat to escape.
Well, you know, the real cooking method of that, even the Hawaiian way, it's a pressure cooker.
Yeah.
That's why they don't let no steam come out, because the second a steam comes out, it burns.
All the food went on top, gets covered with more leaves.
The banana leaves, and then the leaves.
Then the sacks, the wet burlap sacks, and then to seal it all up, put a tarp, some turf down just for weight, bricks all the way around, and some heavy logs just to keep everything in. And everything's gonna be cooking
like a pressure cooker, or like they said, the microwave. The microwave emu.
Okay, so it's been about 3.5 hours. The Umu pit is open. The food's, it's time for it to come out. And then?
Time to eat.
Unreal.
Time to grind.
Time to grind, Johnny. It's time to grind. Look at this. Oh my God. The chicken, I think.
Oh, this is the.
Oh, what happened?
Oh no, he's cleaning up.
This is the other pan of pork.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
This is the fish. What's that fish?
Oh, suck a hot butterfly. Mm-hmm. Fish. Oh. What is that? This is the chicken.
What we have here is the prime rib. Oh. Uncle, check them out.
Look at that prime rib.
Oh, what?
The prime rib is the fe'e. I fe'e with the curry. Oh, I did a curry style. This is the chicken reverse lao lao.
I'm curious to know.
Yeah.
Yep, so we go.
Oh, brother, that looks amazing. Just falls apart. Just falls apart. That's amazing.
Shampoo, shampoo. You don't have shampoo.
Shampoo.
Let me know. Reverse lao lao.
Reverse lao lao.
Huh? Huh. Shigo.
So this is time to grind right now.
This is time. This is it. So amazing. This is so incredible. Let's recap what we did.
Wait, but Tanoai said something earlier.
What?
Something and forget it or something.
This is like the Samoan or Polynesian crock pot.
Yeah.
Set it and forget it.
Yep.
But don't forget out too long because it'll be done. But
exactly.
Put it in, walk away, enjoy your day, come back, the food is ready, like magic.
Set it and forget it. But let's not forget what we did. So yes. Let's remind everybody what we did, starting with the chicken.
This is the reverse lao lao. As you can see, it's fall apart tender.
Yep.
The luau leaf, got the chicken. Let me sample.
Winner.
Yeah, really good. Really
so
good.
So soft.
And then, quite possibly one of my favorite prime ribs ever.
Right there.
In the umu,
yeah,
you started off with oyster sauce and then a prime rib rub.
Yep, prime rib rub. Right there
yes,
for you,
please,
let me know how you like it.
No, I burned. I'm back for fourth. Then we did the pork.
Pork? Mm-hmm.
Cap, you cut them up.
Yeah. Onion, salt, garlic.
Yep. Garlic. And the pork.
Yeah, the pork. With the chili.
And then we had a big chunk that went right on the rocks. Yeah. And it's so tasty. Yeah. Just look
it
at that.
Falls apart.
Look at that.
It just falls apart.
Yeah.
And then Uncle Sam, we did fish.
Yeah, we butterflied the fish, the branzini, and we stuffed it with onions. We had the nice onions from the green onions. And we added a little salt. We added our salty wahini products in there. Amazing, the flavor is just amazing.
We also did the famous Palusami.
Yeah,
oh, Palusami. Yes.
Milk.
And in Tanoai, we did the fe'e.
I put coconut milk in there, but I added some curry.
Very
to give it another flavor.
Yeah, very good.
Curry goes really well with the coconut milk.
And then we had the ulu.
The ulu, straight out of the, you know, you put it right on the coals, and look how soft this is.
Yep, it just falls apart.
And you notice
the candy.
And we love ulu.
We
love ulu.
Yeah,
ulu is good. And then, of course, the
Falif taro.
Falif taro.
So we boiled the taro with the skin on, because we had it frozen.
Mm-hmm. Amazing.
Uncle Sam is a good friend of my family. I've known him since I was a kid. He's a Laie boy. You know, he's born and raised out here. I remember going to his restaurant and his dad's shop, Sam Choy's, Sam Store, and be there all the time, all summer long. So. It was exciting to work with him, and John was my teammate at University of Hawaii, and we were good friends then. So I've seen them off and on throughout the years, but it's always like I just saw them yesterday. So it feels real comfortable to have them here in the house.
Guys, thank you so much for having us over, for feeding us, for teaching us.
Pleasure, pleasure.
A cultural lesson.
But remember,
when Sam Choy's in the kitchen,
you do the cooking.
Shoo-hoo! And now it's time for some Rosalani ice cream.
Woohoo!
It's the opposite of what you want to do. It's the worst thing you can do with that leaf.
Oh, no, stop teasing me.
It's okay, brother.